Friend, welcome to one of the important topic in microprocessor. So today's topic is machine cycle and burst timing diagram. The operation of microprocessor is generally classified into four sub main group. They are operation code fetch, they are memory read and write cycle, and here we have memory read write cycle, input output read machine cycle, and input output write cycle. So we'll discuss about every cycle to first, and so that we can draw a machine cycle burst timing diagram of any instruction given to us. So let's begin with opcode fetch cycle. Opcode fetch cycle is the first operation in any instruction. The microprocessor needs to fetch the data from machine code to memory register where it stored the program before the microprocessor begin to execute any instructions. The operation code fetch cycle is it takes four clock cycles, right? 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, as we know that the four clock cycles are shown in the first section of this figure in the timing diagram, and the register and the address bus pair A15 to A8 holds the higher address of memory. For example, in our if we have a command LXI D, 2050, then this is higher one, and so it holds 20. It holds 20 and it holds 50. And this is a lower address where this 50 is hold. And here we have operation code. For example, in our case, we have LXI. So ALE gets initiated in the initial phase of a cycle when the cycle begins. In IO input output slash memory S1 S2, we have to write 0, 1, 1 for operation code fetch cycle, operation code memory fetch cycle. So we will not go up in detail about these, why we have to write 0, 0, 1. That will be a separate topic and there will be long video. So, the read cycle is only initiated when we have operation code one, when we load an operation code in our memory. So this is about a memory operation code fetch cycle. So you may take a screenshot of this picture, and this is another important memory read machine cycle. And here we have three clock states, and similarly in A15 to A8, the higher subscript we have higher memory address stored and lower memory address for AD7 to AD0. So here we have lower memory address. You just need to remember this. We'll solve practical questions in later video, and we have a data stored in this part. And the ALE gets initiated in the initial phase of cycle. For these AM slash memory, we write 01. 010, and the read cycle gets only activated on the data sections as discussed in the previous video. Screenshot. The third cycle is memory write cycle. The memory write cycle is executed by a processor when we have to write a byte into a memory location. It takes three clock state to execute this machine cycle. Three clock state, and the AD15 to AD8 will take higher order address, and AD7 will take lower order address, and the data is stored in this section, and the ALE gets initiated in this section. Initially gets initiated. And in we have to write 001, and the write, and as we have to write, the write command gets activated, and the write command gets activated in the data section. This is fourth machine cycle. This gets executed when we have to read a data from input output port. We need to read data from input output means like in command, and it has three clock states. AD7, the higher bit, A15 to A8, we have input-output port address. AD7 to AD0, we have input-output port address, and we have data stored in this. ALE gets initiated initially, and we have to write in this section 110. This gets activated when the data gets activated. Screenshot. This is a last cycle, input-output write cycle. This is activated in the command output.
when we have to write. So when we have to write an input output peripherals, so it takes 3 clock states. And as similarly in input output read cycle, we have to write the port address in this section AD15 to A8. AD7 AD7 to AD0 we have to write port address for the initial part, for the first clock period, and after second clock period we have a data. We've tried to fetch a data. The ALE gets initiated in this section. WR gets activated when we try to write a data. WR gets activated in this section. We are at 101. Make sure you take the screenshot of these. These were the basic cycles, and if we remember how to write these basic cycle on our own, we can draw a instruction cycle or the bus timing diagram for any instruction, because all those instructions are composed of these cycle, either of these cycles, right? So thank you for watching. We'll practice more examples in other video. Goodbye. Till then, don't forget to subscribe.